أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
Qarni is a story. That sets an example for all the Muslims as how even without meeting the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one may still earn Allah's favor and his pleasure on account of his unflinching love for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Awais Qarni, may Allah bless him, could never meet the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in person, but he is arguably the only person in Islamic history who is said to have been accorded the status of Sahabi, companion, by none other than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. To be a companion, it is required the criterion of meeting the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while having faith. Imam Muslim named one full chapter in his one of the most reliable tomes of hadith in Qarni's name. The virtues of Awais Qarni in Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, it records hadith quoting Umar ibn al-Khattab, who said, "I heard Allah's messenger, peace be upon him, saying, there would come to you Owais Amir of Qarn, a branch of the Murid tribe, along with the reinforcement of the people of Yemen. He had been suffering from leprosy, which would have been cured but for the space of a dirham. His treatment with his mother would have been very kind. If he would take an oath in the name of Allah for something, he would honor it. Ask him to beg forgiveness for you from Allah in case it is possible for you." Qarni was born in Asir, region of Saudi Arabia, 594 CE. His father Amr was a God-fearing person. He gave Islamic education to his son but died, leaving Awais an orphan at a young age. The family was poor and could not afford higher education for him. He devoted him to praying, fasting and service to his mother. Awais had profound love for Islam and its messenger. Awais رضي الله تعالى عنه learned that there is a great reward in Islam for serving parents. His mother was sick and blind, so he devoted himself solely to the service of his mother. He was 28 years of age when Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had migrated to Medina Munawwara. He had a keen desire to visit him but was preoccupied with the service of his sick mother. Yet he would keep a tab on the developments in Hijaz. When he heard about the sad news of the Battle of Uhud, 625 CE, when a tenth of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was martyred, Qarni, out of love for him, broke all his teeth. Thus was his love for the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew about Qarni and his love for him. He once told Umar ibn al-Khattab about Qarni and had predicted that Umar would meet Qarni after his departure from the world. He gave all the details about him and advised him to seek prayers for his forgiveness and for the whole Ummah. The companion asked if they could see him, but the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, "No, only Umar bin Khattab and Ali would meet him," and gave identity marks of Qarni. He directed Umar and Ali, "When you see him, convey to him my salam and ask him to pray for my Ummah." During Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's last days, he asked Umar and Ali to pass him jubba, the blessed cloak, to Qarni and ask him to pray for the forgiveness of the Muslim Ummah. This demonstrates the exalted status of Qarni. The Prophet is said to have remarked, "Is the best among Tabi'in, second generation of the companions." Qarni rubbed the blessed cloak over his face and eyes and kissed it. When he finally received it, the blessed cloak, it is said, is preserved in Istanbul, Turkey. Referring to Qarni, the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam once told his companions, "There is a person in my ummah whose prayers would bring forgiveness to as many sinners as the number of the sheep in the tribes of Rabia and Madar." The two tribes of Rabia and Madar were well known for raising sheep during the time of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Usair bin Jabir reported that when people from Yemen come to help the Muslim army during battle, Caliph Omar would ask him, "Is there among you Owais bin Amir?" He continued finding him out until he met Qarni. He told him the saying of Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam about him and asked him for his prayer and said, "Where do you intend to go?" He said, "Kufa." Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, "Let me write a letter for you to its corner." But Awais said, "I love to live among the poor people." Umar was impressed with his simple personality and asked Awais Qarni to pray for him. He replied, "I pray for the forgiveness of everyone at the end of every prayer. If you keep your faith in Allah and His Messenger, peace be upon him, you will receive my prayer in your graves." Here is the famous invocation of Awais Qarni: "O Allah, you created me when I was not worthy of mention, and you provided for me when I had nothing, and I wronged my soul and sinned, and I confess my guilty. If you forgive me, that will in no way reduce your sovereignty, and if you punish me, that will in no way augment your authority. You can find others to punish besides me, but I can find no one to forgive me but you. Truly, you are the most merciful of those who show mercy." The Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Awais will come to Medina to meet me, but he will not find me physically, for I shall then be united with my Lord." When the people of Qarni began to revering him and considering him a saint on account of his status in Islam, he left Qarni for Kufa, where he engaged in imparting Islamic education. Later, he took part in the unfortunate Battle of Siffin, 37 AH, where he was finally wounded, subsequently dying at the age of 63. He was buried at Al-Raqqa, Syria, a Grand Al-Zariya Mosque, as Jamia Awais Qarni stands at Qarni in Asir region, and another Awais Qarni Masjid in Ilford, UK. The love of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the boon that can be achieved without meeting him. This opens the door for millions of Muslims living in different areas and eras at the world. The life of Awais Qarni encouraged us to love Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, though we have not seen him and high ranks as caught by Awais.
Sadaqallah.